Hey guys, welcome to JPlays. I am Iceman. This is my playthrough of Dawn of War 2, the Chaos Rising expansion. On day 7. Well, as much as I don't want to do it, I should probably do this. It's the last optional mission left, and my people probably need the experience, so...
Commander, the Vandis heresy continues to spread. Vandis and Black Legion forces have taken Spire Legis. They have erected artillery batteries and emplacements that make a large-scale assault impossible. If you can disable these defenses, however, the Imperial Guard can retake the Spire. If not, the population of Legis will remain at the mercy of these heretics and demons. Commander, the Vandis heresy continues to spread. The Vandis heretics are using field generators to power their batteries. Destroy these generators and the Black Temple's defending them, and the batteries will fall silent. Foul sorcerers have also established warp portals which allow the Black Legion to bring in reinforcements. Sealing these portals should stem the tide of enemies long enough for you to destroy the generators.
Sure thing.
You are sending me to Spire Legis, Commander.
Is that an order, Sergeant Thaddeus?
No. No, forgive me, Commander. I request to be part of the Strike Force. Long ago, Spire Legis was my home. I will not see its people sacrificed to chaos.
So be it. It's a shame that you can only take 4 people with you. If only if it was like the full amount, or 5, or even better 6. Because then you could have some really big battle squads, like in Dawn of War 1. But no matter.
A rift in the warp. As long as it remains open, the enemy can summon reinforcements.
Key targets are on your map display, Commander. If you destroy the enemy's generators and strongholds, the Imperial Guard can retake Spire Legis.
A temple? They have established a temple to the powers of chaos.
Destroy this foul den. There is no time to waste.
Thank you.
Emperor!
Leveling up on this one.
Thank you.
yeah.
Under fire. things. The Rosa's fragile guardsmen can advance without trembling now.
Easy mission. Damn, I've got some Terminator gear, but it's cursed. Question is, what is the max level in this expansion? Is it 30 or 40? Because that determines a lot of things. Because if it's 30, then I should definitely go for that and try and get along here. If it's 40 though, then I could actually start doing along here. Or down here. Ah, and just did a quick Google search, and it is 30. So that means I've only got 3 levels left, in which case I should definitely go for this one. I don't think I'll be able to get to that, though. Damn, that is a shame. Epic armor, too. But if I wear it, then it's plus 4 corruption. Damn it. Interesting. Could give infiltration to everyone. Everyone. But probably increased firepower is better. If if the level cap was 40 though, I would totally go for it. Now, when I use the Ancient Defender, which is the healing ability, he can still shoot at the same time as his healing. That's great. Though he does stay stationary. Oh. Well. Here, and then here. Stern guard, squad trait. Ah, interesting.
Thank you, Commander. The 85th Vendelund has begun its assault on the Spire. The heretics are resisting, but without their defensive guns, they will crumble. It is good to see them suffering the wages of their sins. DeRosa out.
Off to do a brother's return.
We have an urgent message from Planet Typhon. It comes from Techmarine Martellus. We thought him lost in the Tyranid War, but he survived. He needs your help, Commander.
Techmarine Martellus, to any Blood Ravens capable of receiving. I am transmitting from the Astronomic Array Station in the Typhon Islands. Orc looters have been a recurring threat since my arrival. However, at dawn this day, I detected a graver threat. Chaos Space Marines. I fear they want the Array for themselves. I risk damaging the Array by sending this message, but I require support. Mars and Terra, power levels are dropped.
You have to try not to do permanent damage to the Array.
Are you receiving?
Sergeant Tarkus! Thank the Omnissiah! I am defending the Array, but the traitor legions are here!
Retribution, prepare to provide close support.
Revive him.
My thanks, Commander. I am glad to see you again.
We had thought you lost when your Thunderhawk went down, Martellus. How did you survive?
A story for another time, Tarkus. The heretics will surely try for the Array again any moment.
We cannot stay here defending this relic for all eternity, Techmarine.
Agreed, but we cannot leave the valuable data in its cogitator for the enemy to take. Strike Cruiser, this is Techmarine Martellus. Deploy power generators at the following coordinates.
Enemy has a
killed him.
initiate a cogitation transfer right to secure the records. Just keep the enemy from destroying those generators.
This place belongs to the orcs!
Greenskin looters.
A fight on two fronts, then.
The orcs are using a gate to access the complex. We should seal it.
The greenskins will just go around, Cyrus.
Exactly. Directly into the traitor's space marines.
Our communications are under assault.
Capture. Hostile movement up ahead. Locked in melee.
Then go around the other way, you kids! And kill every Yumi you see!
I could kill this shit, but you have not yet.
Provide cover.
Bloody hell.
Thank you.
Even the deepest Tyranid hive was as foul as that scum.
Indeed, Avitus. Commander, Cogitita recovery is complete. We can safely leave this place.
Now you can tell us the story of your survival, Martellus.
Good boss battle.
This victory will long be remembered in the halls of glory.
The boss battles in this one actually require tactics.
Thank you for your timely intervention, Commander. I will initiate the repair rites for the items you have recovered. In particular, I shall restore our Terminator armor. Commander, I have been reviewing the data we recovered from the Astronomic Array. I believe the ancient Space Hulk designated Judgment of Carrion is about to appear in this sector. It may allow us to identify our traitor. Should you require more information, I am at your disposal.
That level, I remember.
The Judgment of Carrion is a conglomeration of ancient vessels which have become adrift in space and time. It travels at random, spending decades or even centuries in the warp.
If I may, its travels are not entirely random. Only the Emperor can know what horrific planes the Judgment of Carrion has visited. But its recorded appearances have all been in this sector or in one of its neighbors.
Yes, and because of that, the Astronomic Array had a detailed record of past appearances. A distinctive pattern of warp anomalies preceded each appearance.
And that pattern is occurring again.
Precisely.
How does any of this blather help identify the traitor?
The machine spirit aboard the Retribution is not sufficient to remove the masking on the message you recovered. But there are references to a far more ancient and wiser logic engine aboard the Judgment of Carrion. With it, I can identify the heretic.
It's a shame there's no way to remove the corruption from an item. That's good. So that gives every squad I have, I hope it's every squad, plus one stamina.
Just how did you survive, Martellus?
Yes, a good question.
As you may recall, I was aboard a Thunderhawk during the climactic battle with the Tyranids.
I also recall it being blown from the sky.
A Thunderhawk is a resilient craft. Instead of destroying us outright, the Tyranid attack sent us into a desperate dive into the jungle. My brother pilot used all his experience to guide us into the highlands, where the infestation was less severe. He did not survive the crash landing. I was left alone. No transmitter survived, and my own cybernetic enhancements were severely damaged. It took me months to successfully enact the repair rites to regain my mobility. I spent the rest of the past year battling my way through to the Astronomic Array.
Your perseverance does the chapter proud, Martellus.
Perhaps. but I am glad to be in the confines of a mighty strike cruiser once more.
Let's see. Is it to everyone or just my current squad? Things to remember. Alright, so someone that's not in my squad right now. Ooh. So, if I look at Thaddeus, he's literally 1 point off getting the Vanguard Veterans trait. If I use it now, he should be already there. Good.
Thank you.
extra location.
Your cursed ship is hiding, Tech Marine.
Hold your tongue, Avidus.
The Judgment of Carrion.
Commander, I have uncovered another transmission from the traitor. We should review it before launching another mission. Like Martellus, I have been trying to identify the traitor using our shipboard cogitators.
Have you made any progress?
Of a sort. This message was in our own transmission tomes.
Angelos has us charging around the sector on the Retribution. They know about me, or at least that I exist. Only the Vox Cloak Invocator has masked my identity thus far.
The traitor is here, aboard the Retribution. He is one of us.
Mm-hmm.
We need to reactivate the ancient logic engine aboard the Judgment of Carrion. To recover the proper activation rights, you must locate data slates hidden in the surrounding decks. Because you will be operating deep within the Space Hulk, the Retribution can only offer very limited support. Jump packs will be useless in the confined space, although teleport systems will function. The logic engine is secured in a sealed vault. Only the engine's activation rights will open the vault and grant us access.
Xenos and demons infest the Judgment of Carrion, Commander. But the lingering warp energies in the ship pose a far graver danger. With prolonged exposure, such energies could drive even the bravest space marine to madness. The boarding party should return to the Retribution as soon as it can.
This seems like a likely one I'll get corruption on. Because I am the type that takes my time on these missions, but... Tyranids.
Commander, you must locate ancient data slates to access the vault. They should be in data racks of some sort.
We have no time to waste. The foul resonance of the warp is already palpable.
Steady. The battlefield is growing.
Be vigilant for other vials, or signs of an apothecary.
Commander, the rules indicate Bonaparte still serves in the Chapter Honor Guard.
How can that be?
creature nearby. Remember, when connected to their synapse web, all Tyranids become deadlier.
Hostile movement up ahead, brothers.
My craft is dead.
Exercise caution. Tyranids aboard these derelicts can evolve to suit the environment.
Yes, I sense powerful psychic echoes. Even against the warp energies.
We have engaged.
Thank you.
them all! Let there be blood!
The warp is making itself felt, Commander. We must hurry.
Oh, that's right.
Another fallen brother. Veteran Lucanus, also of the 5th Company.
And another reductor vial.
Martellus, what do the roles say about Brother Lucanus?
Killed in the Karava campaign.
I was at Karava. I recall no Lucanus.
Commander, both Bonaparte and Lucanus served in an expedition aboard the Judgment of Carrion. I shall try to uncover more about this expedition.
Xenos in the gantries. Get ready.
objective taken.
Another fallen brother, and another gene seed.
Sergeant Sarmadon, 5th Company.
Another member of the same expedition. The records list Apothecary Galen as the leader.
Which explains the reductor vials.
But not why they were left behind.
Our way.
There's a data slate on the door. Xeno's detected.
Eliminate them. The logic engine must not be damaged.
The foe is in danger of range.
The logic engine.
This is Galen. I no longer know how long I've been on this forsaken derelict. So many brothers dead. And the voice of Ulcair cackles from every shadow. It is hungry. It wants the holy gene seed in each of us. I must hide the reductor vials. Even the demon cannot know the entire Space Hulk.
Commander, that was some sort of Vox recording from centuries ago. I will analyze it as best I can.
The enemy is destroying a key structure.
What structure?
This victory will long be remembered in the Halls of Glory.
Your prize had best be worth sending us into that foul place, Tech Marine.
Recovering Gene Seed alone is worth the risk, Avitus.
I will begin analysis of the logic engine right away, Commander. We have also received several distress signals from across the sector. The following transmission is repeating on secure chapter channels.
Come, Blood Ravens! Face me in battle if you dare! I am Aragost of the Black Legion! I await you on Aurelia!
The scum is challenging us like an undercity pit fighter.
If he wants a battle, I will give him one.
This must be a trap.
Mm-hmm.
Does it matter?
Commander, the Vandis heretics are gaining ground hourly. Captain Angelos has sent no blood ravens to aid Meridian. I need your help. Please come to Meridian as soon as you can. DeRosa out.
We have located the store of reductor vials left aboard the Judgment of Carrion. Recovering additional Blood Raven's genetic material would be a great service to the chapter.
One thing I'm wondering is, if you put on a corrupted equipment, can you cleanse it of the corruption? I was just reading about corrupted stuff. It doesn't look like you can purify it. In that case, let's see. The annoying bit is it doesn't tell you how many points of corruption you got. Damn, that's got some good stats. The annoying bit is, though, if I put that on, it's good that it's +3 redemption, but as soon as I put that on, I can't use the healing item. That's the main negative. If I was still able to use these, I would totally equip the Terminator armor. Just to be able to get that with two more levels. Soft target. I don't think I'll be able to get to there in time, but I'll make the attempt. I need some better Terminator weapons though. I need some ranged stuff, like assault cannons and stuff. Give me that, and then I'll start moving more people over to Terminator armor. I'll try them out in the gear anyway. Give some very nice bonuses. Damn, that is some good stats. Alright, well, I'm going to end this one here. Hope you guys have enjoyed watching this video. If you'd like to be notified about when I go about putting up more videos in the Dawn of War 2 Chaos Rising playthrough series, be sure to subscribe to the YouTube side of things, or click follow or subscribe on Twitch. And with that, guys, have a good one.